We signed this MOU with Lockheed Martin. It's a matter of honor for BEML to sign this MOU with Lockheed Martin, and this signature precedes months of parlays we had with them. They visited us, we had a series of discussions, and it was only when they were convinced that BEML would be able to take it forward, they have signed this. They have asked us to bid for certain items for the F-16, which they source from the various worldwide suppliers. So if we are able to successfully supply them these items and they meet the exacting technological standards of Lockheed Martin, we would be in business.
Fair enough. In order to meet some of these Lockheed's requirements, will there be any incremental capex from your side?
At the moment, we have huge amount of capacity within the company. Perhaps you are aware that BEML has three verticals. We have a mining and construction, rail and metro, and defense. So, and we have four factories. Each of these factories has certain capacities. So first we would try to utilize the capacity within, and if required, certain machinery, for example, in the aerospace division recently, we have already made investments to the tune of 40 to 100 crores. If anything more is required, we would look at the cost benefit, and with the outsourcing policy of ours and the push that the government is giving to the MSME sector, we would like to utilize the ecosystem of MSMEs. So almost 40 to 100 crores we have invested, and some more investment is on the anvil.
Right. Just to understand, we may be jumping the gun here, but essentially what kind of a revenue opportunity could this tie-up with Lockheed be?
See, I think at the moment, this is just the beginning of a relationship, and I can just take you to the example of almost 15 years back when we started making metro coaches. We supplied a handful of metro coaches to Delhi Metro. And today we are in a position to supply 300 metro coaches. So I think, in the short term, it will not be fair to look at what is going to be the revenue out of this. But I can assure you, the potential is huge. And given the fact that aviation and aerospace is going through a big boom, for example, in the country, I am told, the civilian aircraft, another 1600 is going to be added in the next 5 years. At the moment, we have something like 700 aircrafts. The government is talking of setting up 100 airports. Now, whether it is civil or whether it is defense application, aerospace, there's a huge amount of commonality. So I would say we will be able to ride the boom the way India is poised to expand.
Yeah. Right, sir. To understand, sir, are there any other tie-ups that you are exploring right now with any other major defense players that you would be looking at?
Yes, we are exploring tie-ups with other companies as well. For example, in the offset, we are talking to two very major companies in the world, and hopefully we should be tying something up with them soon.
Right, sir. Give us an indication. You spoke that aerospace is going to be a key growth driver going forward. What's the kind of opportunity that you're looking in aerospace? What's the kind of revenue turnover that you have in aerospace currently?
I think it's fair that I should tell you what the current aerospace division in BEML is doing. We have a 25-acre plot in the SEZ in Bangalore. We are in the process of constructing a shed there so we can look at these export opportunities. In Mysore, I have already supplied almost about 130 odd, if I'm not mistaken, missile aggregates for Akash missile. This is section 4 and section 5, which is basically certain exotic metals, maraging steel, titanium. Absolute precision kind of work is required in that. So we have already done that. That's maybe to the tune of 40 to 50 crores. We have also been approved as a lead vendor for MRSAM. Then we are looking at GSE and GHE, which is the ground support equipment and ground handling equipments. We had also in the past supplied some airborne structures for the Su-30. So all those are being done. We are looking at bomb pallets. We are looking at aircraft towing tractors that we have supplied in the past. So my aerospace division at the moment is looking at a turnover of almost about 40 to 50 crores per year at the moment. But I think this is going to multiply in the years to come.
Point taken, sir. Lastly, before we let you go, what's the current order book looking like? What's the kind of execution timeline that you're working with right now?
That's a good question. At the moment, we are close to crossing the 10,000 crore mark for the order book, which is substantial. This is the first time in the history we will cross that number. And so that's going to take us, at the moment our turnover is about between 3,000 and 4,000. So I have orders to the tune of 2 years.